evening, everyone, and welcome to the Brookfield Board of Selectmen's meeting for Tuesday, April 26th. Ask everyone to please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you, everyone. All right. Entertain a motion to approve the expense warrant and wire warrant for April 19th.
I will make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Announcements. The local public access committee is seeking members. The committee is also seeking videographers to tape meetings and local events. Those interested should contact Ms. Mahoney at local access, LOCALACCESS at brookfieldma.us. Mr. Wallenin, District Aide to Senator Ann Goby, will be holding office hours at the Brookfield Town Hall from 2 to 3 p.m. Wednesday, May 18th. All are welcome. I'd also like to announce that the new signs that were donated to the town of Brookfield are up. Look absolutely amazing.
Yes, they do.
And again, thank you to the couple that had donated those. Mr. and Mrs. J, thank
you
very much.
They look so nice.
Unbelievably nice. Any other announcements? Anybody wish to address the board this evening? Welcome, sir.
Evening.
Yes, all of them are. I had the same realization, trust me.
Hey, when can you meet with the advisory board? You going to discuss that tonight?
We were not. I was actually going to look to you.
Could you give us a date so I can go back and tell them?
I was going to look to you for a date after. You are low. I looked to you for.
Well, it's good for you.
It was on purpose. It was strategic. I was going to look to you after you got the articles to let us know what you thought.
Okay, you'll do that tonight.
Yeah, so okay. Once you get those and review them, then you can.
Then we're going to do the budget and the articles together?
I would think so.
Okay, that's fine.
Now, you're meeting tomorrow evening, right?
And Friday.
Oh, and Friday, okay.
So we'll get those to you for that.
Get it done.
Yep.
What about Friday meeting for the annual town meeting? Are you going to do any changes on that?
I heard a rumor, and yes. Linda would have to confirm.
Okay. We had our first roundtable discussion today. It was a meeting. It was very informal. I chaired it with all the different committee head. I mean, different boards.
Department heads. Okay.
And some of the employees came also. And they would like to know if it's a possibility if we could change the town meeting, because it's on June 3rd, because that is graduation weekend. And they said a lot of people will not be able to be attending the town meeting, because if I remember right, we usually have it the following week.
Well, if I remember correctly, we've never calculated graduation into a town meeting ever.
No, but we've never had it this early. We've usually had it the second week.
I believe it
June.
Was, no, I think last year was the first week of June as well.
I thought that they were just asking if it's a possibility if we could change
it. Last town meeting was the first week, first Friday the 5th of June. And that was a rumor that I heard, and I'm not opposed to it at all. There's actually a proposal, I think it's from the bylaw committee, to change it to Mondays. I'm one of three. We haven't discussed that yet. I don't want a bylaw saying what day that we're going to have it. I think the selectmen should choose. Mm. We think we have a pretty good pulse on it. But in regards to changing it from the 3rd, did they recommend the 10th or bring it back to May?
No, bring it back to the following week, the next week.
So June 10th?
Yeah, is that right, Karen? They said the following week.
Yes.
They'll bring it back to June, yeah.
They'll give us another week too, though.
Yes.
Yep. Are we held to Fridays?
No.
Okay.
That's
so
what I'm trying to.
Well, we do have a bylaw that states that we shall hold the town meeting a week after the first Friday after the town election. And we've never followed it.
Yeah.
Okay.
Until a few years ago when we didn't have the cherry sheet figures,
right,
and this is why we did the later.
We have the cherry sheets. We just don't have a final budget.
Yeah. But didn't the state say that we didn't have to hold it on that particular?
We don't.
Time?
Yeah, we don't have to hold it.
The selectmen set the meeting.
Yeah.
Which just flies in the face of that bylaw, so.
I just have a suggestion. Mm-hmm. We've been having a separate organization and whatnot. We started to do Mondays because people work weekends and a lot of people have off Mondays. So that Mondays, we've held two events on Mondays and had better participation. So the idea of a Monday is probably not a bad idea.
Mondays are worst days for me.
Oh, I think, what Monday events have we had?
No, we have, no, I just had another organization where we started to have meetings, annual meetings on a Monday because of people working the weekends and having, actually having Mondays off.
We discussed that a little bit this morning, and they didn't think a Monday would be a good day either.
Okay.
Because like I had spoken, and I said, I remember we used to have Monday specials, and we couldn't even get our quorum of 30.
You'd have to get on the phone and call.
And I used to have to go over, the fire department met on Mondays. I'd have to go to the fire department and get the guys to come over here, so we had a quorum of 30. So Mondays isn't good.
And we've had this discussion for years. Yep. There's really no good day.
It's no good day.
Nope.
Yeah, it's hard. We've tried out.
Friday the 10th, let's do it.
We've never tried a Saturday. I like the idea of a Saturday, but families are out on Saturdays.
Hardwick does Saturdays at noontime.
That's why I liked it. It was a very good attendance.
Yeah, they have a very, because I'm friends with the town clerk up there, and she said they have a very good attendance on a Saturday.
I just think people only come out when there's big money issues.
So, Linda, what did you come to at that meeting? What day did you come up with?
Well, we didn't come to a day. We were just suggesting. We just were saying it's hard, actually, any date to get here.
So do we want to set it to the 10th? Move it up a week?
Yeah. I think that's a good idea.
Now you get Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, based on what we've just discussed. Yeah.
But no,
those
we really
are the 3 days
to
choose from.
We were saying everybody has something going. You can't make everybody happy.
And we had this.
Well, I'm not trying to. I'm just trying to get more people to attend.
We had this discussion a couple months ago when we set the 3rd. So I'll entertain a motion to change the town meeting date to the 10th, pending permission from the elementary school.
What date is that following?
Friday.
It's
well,
a Friday.
See, now we haven't done any change.
We moved it up a week.
All that discussion
we moved it up a week. We moved it up
because,
1 week.
Because of the graduations.
Yeah.
Approval from the elementary school.
I know, but we're trying to get off of Friday.
Well,
that was my discussion here.
I tried.
What happened? I understand that, Dave.
Huh?
I thought the discussion was to try to get it off of Friday, and I was trying to get some input from you three. Now all of a sudden
we had that discussion 2 months ago, and I really don't want to go down that road again.
We discussed
Friday this morning. Friday was the best
Karen,
day.
Right? It was really. Nobody really had a good day.
They didn't have a day. They just thought that it was a bad day. That the 3rd was a bad day.
The 3rd was the bad day.
Do I have a motion?
I will. I'll make a motion.
Yeah, and you have a second.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you.
All right, I did my best.
Anything else? That was it?
For the moment.
Thank you, sir. Anybody else wish to address the board this evening? Hearing nobody, I'm going to entertain a motion to open the special town meeting warrant.
Okay. Could I
can
say
I get a,
something?
Can I get a motion, or do you want to say something first?
No, I would you have a motion.
Oh, sure. Do I have a second?
Second, sure.
Okay. All in favor?
Aye.
All
right. Uh-huh. Okay, something that was brought up at the meeting this morning. Everyone was there. They said if an article is not accepted tonight to go on to the warrant, they told us that there's not really enough time to revise it because the warrant is closed, you know, the night that it's reviewed. And if they don't have, they don't have enough time, and they wondered if there was anything that, you know, we could talk about, you know, and make some revisions.
So did they give you specific warrants or articles that...
No, like say if tonight we discuss somebody's article and we decide not to put it on.
Yeah.
You know, they said they would like to be notified if the article was not going on the warrant. They don't want to find out about it once the warrant is printed up.
I'm not opposed to letting them readdress it at our next meeting and reopen it if we have to reopen it.
Oh, all right.
Sure.
Especially with moving it up a week.
And with what we have here, I mean, there's going to be some questions.
Yeah.
Because this is what they were asking.
Were you able to get this last night for review?
Yeah.
Instead of just cramming it down tonight?
Yeah. No, well, I looked at it last night.
I looked at it earlier today.
I want everyone to have a visual on it.
I just didn't get the last.
So like I said, they would just like to be notified if their article isn't going on the warrant. And I said we always can reopen the warrant. So that was
100%.
One thing that came out of the meeting this morning.
I see everything here needing to go on the warrant. Talk about it.
I disagree.
Okay.
One of two
so
things.
You're not opposed like to reopening the warrant if somebody came in and stated their case?
No.
Okay. I think that's a good thing.
All right. So special town meeting. Mm-hmm. Correct me if I'm wrong, Karen. We have 6.
These are the ones that I went, because I had gone through them the other day, and I picked the ones that I thought should be on the special town meeting.
I think all, there aren't even any of the new ones that have to go on.
Basically, I think.
Well, the new ones were all annual town meetings.
Annual, yeah. So I went through, because a lot of these are like transfers and different things.
Well, unfortunately, we still have to deal with the mess of the, lack of better words, embezzlement from a former town employee.
Right.
So that's more than half of them here.
Yeah, that's what some of them are.
So the first one, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate, transfer, or borrow. This is another thing Karen had asked yesterday. People have their own ways, their own set ways. I would just like to be upfront and honest with the townspeople. All these are pretty much gonna be transfers.
Yeah, that's what they are.
So I think we should publish them in transfers as opposed to four different entities.
Yes, I think that's fine, too.
Because it states it right here, because this would technically be a transfer. So transfer or borrow, $1,380 to the Union 61 preschool program account. The money needs to be covered for the theft from the receipts from that department. And the insurance money has been taken in and was certified as free cash. So it would have to be transferred from free cash to the Union 61 preschool. So I'll entertain a motion to place Article 1 on special town meeting.
I will make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Number two, to see if the town will vote to transfer $20,000 approximately to group health insurance account. Take any action relative thereto. Entertain a motion to place said article.
I will make that motion.
Second.
This is for the reason that we didn't have enough money to cover it. Three, to see if the town will vote to raise appropriate transfer. This would be transfer $100 to the water surplus account. Again, the cover the theft from the free cash. Entertain motion to place.
I will make that motion.
I'll second, but for discussion, can we go back to two?
For discussion for two?
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to take the motion off the floor. Let's go back to two.
Okay.
Approximately. Is that number, typically you can't go higher if it's higher. So is that sufficient to cover whatever needs to happen?
Betty and Sandy are pretty usually good with their numbers.
The word approximately bothers me.
I did hear Sandy say something like it could be 24.
Then we need to make it 24, not...
All right, well, I mean, but that's not carved in stone either. That's why we did approximately.
Before we post this, we can actually put the correct number.
Now,
All right.
Have we put more people on the insurance?
I don't know. That's something that Betty put on.
Because I know that's a lot of times that's why we go up on the money.
She brought this up a couple weeks ago as well.
So we just have to verify before printing.
Well, the printing doesn't have a dollar amount in it.
No.
The motion on the floor would be the
it's
exact
the motion
amount.
On the
so
floor.
We literally have until the day.
The
only issue is if we have money to cover it, and this would probably be from free cash. So we should be fine.
Okay. All right. Thank you.
So number three, entertain a motion to place.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Item number four, transfer $1,625 to the after-school program from free cash, same issue.
I'll make that motion.
Second. Place. Any discussion?
Yep.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Number five, to see if the town will vote to transfer $3,030 from the Union 61 preschool program account for the same reason. Entertain motion to place.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion?
Oh.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Six and seven. Six, to see if the town will vote to transfer a sum of money to the snow and ice account for FY16 snow and ice deficit or take any action relative thereto. This would be for the amount that they actually spent. We did, Dave, correct me, was it $20,000 that we vote to deficit spend?
On the
snow and ice account?
Snow and ice.
All right. That was just up to $20,000. I don't know if they spent that, and that'll be the number that
so
Cindy,
we want to, yeah, we'll get the number
Cindy,
from Cindy.
But regardless, we have to take care of it because we voted to deficit spend.
We do. I'll make the motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Seven, to see if the town will vote to transfer a sum of money to the stabilization account or take any action relative thereto. This one, I have no idea what...
I don't know. That Betty, over the phone, she asked me to write that one.
Mike's not here.
Well, she's talking about taking... Ooh. I know what that is.
Oh, this is for the
because remember how we gotten the money back
fleet
from
repair.
The storm, and it
storm.
Became
this was
free
to
cash.
Make good on our promise
That's
on the floor.
That's what it was. Yeah,
very good. Thank you, Linda. Entertain a motion to place.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
There is no figure on here, but it was...
60, wasn't it?
Wasn't it, 65, I think?
At least 60.
I thought it was 65.
I'd say at least, it was 60-something, I remember.
But we can obviously get that from Mike.
Okay.
All right, was that it, Karen, for special town?
Yes.
All right, so I'll entertain a motion to close the special town.
I'll make that motion.
All right, this is going to be a little bit all over the place, I apologize, because the new ones that came in today. So if we could, let's just take the ones that came in new today, if you guys have separated those.
Yep.
So I'll entertain a motion to open the annual town meeting warrant.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, so I have the advisory committee's recommendation for voting equipment.
Okay.
Want to pull that one?
Yep.
We had the discussion with the advisory committee, I had the discussion with the town clerk, I haven't had the discussion with the moderator. I like the idea, but I'm just too darn cheap, so I'm going to refrain from saying anything else besides that. So I'm going to entertain a motion to place, to see if the town will vote to raise, appropriate, transfer, borrow a sum of approximately $3,400 for electronic voting equipment.
I'll make that motion.
I'll second it.
Discussion?
Okay, I had talked to, I had a call on something else, I had talked to town council, and she told me a lot of towns are going with these voting, and I told her how you would mention that you were only like going to get 125 little...
Clickers.
Clickers. And she says, maybe you should go for a few more than 125 clickers. And also, she said there are some companies that will come out and give you a free demonstration to do this.
I'm working on that, too.
Yeah, that's what she had also told me, so I just wanted to pass the info on to you.
So I think, Dave, have you taken a tally of the largest town meeting? Have you gone back into the records and found out how many?
I haven't done that, no, we base it on 125. See, the clickers are 25 apiece, but we have to have some kind of a formula, when people come in, they're going to have to sign these things out, and when they leave the meeting, they're going to have to check their name off to return their clicker, and their name will be crossed off the list.
And what if...
We haven't figured that out at all, just yet.
So the number is an issue, and what if they don't return the clicker?
We don't know that yet. That's up, we have a discussion on it.
Before the town meeting?
Yes.
Clarence, issues?
Yeah, my thought is to leave it to the town.
Yeah.
Leave it to the town?
Now, this wouldn't be used at till, what, next year, or if you got it, or would you...
Reuse it the next special.
At the next special.
Well, whenever you get it.
Yeah, whenever you get it. But I mean, I think I would advise, maybe if you would have somebody come out and do a free demo at the special, and then go forward with it, maybe for the next annual town meeting.
Well, this is vote to get the money, so there's really no time.
Yeah, I mean, that's the only suggestion I was just making today.
My only suggestion, and you've already done it, is shop around.
Yeah.
Different places.
We've been doing that, yes.
Yeah.
I checked with the town clerk, and he said his end was a lot more money than what I thought.
Yeah, it is.
All right, so any further discussion?
So I'm going to stay with the 125 for now?
I'm staying with a figure of 3,400, just placing it.
Okay.
I'm...
All right, all in favor of placing said article?
Aye.
Is that number in now or not?
No.
No.
We'll number them later. So aye, unanimous. The Board of Trustees, I believe this is from, yeah, Library, voted and approved an article for the annual town meeting, article to see if the town will vote to raise an appropriate transfer, borrow a sum of money for the library building maintenance account, and take any action relative to, thereto. $10,000, the funds will be used for maintenance of the Merrick Public Library to remove, repair, and reinstall the large east-facing pulpit window and frame. The trustees and staff continue to prioritize upgrades, maintenance, and town's historic, to the town's historic building. Entertain a motion to place said article?
I will make that motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussion?
Just to say, I was up at the library the other day, and she had showed me the window, and she said that, you know, they wanted to repair it, because they want to keep the building historic, and she said that was the best price that they came up with.
They maintain that building very well.
I know they do.
So this is not opposing, this is just a thought.
Two sides to every sword.
Here you go. So back to the mass historical money and grants and the like, have have we ever applied for money for the library for Mass Historical?
That would be on her. I would say yes.
I think they have.
They're a pretty diligent committee.
Yeah, they're very good.
And I'm good. And so the other thought that I have is that it's 15,000, minimum number of grant writing, the project value is $15,000. Mm-hmm. So if you were to take this 10,000, you could double your money. And again, I'm not thinking for this for a year from now, as they look.
Every year they have an article for repairs of that building.
So I'm just thinking a way to double your money is that if
so. Maybe go talk to her tomorrow.
I will.
Actually, tonight she'll be there tonight.
Yeah.
After the meeting,
it's just a way to double your money. Yeah.
Okay.
All in favor of placing?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Now we're going.
Police chief's cruiser. He has requested, there's actually two articles here, he's requesting $35,000 for the purchase of a new cruiser. We met with the advisory committee, and unless they do differently, we've advised to place $100,000 into that account with the purpose of this cruiser and a potential fire chief vehicle. So we can go one of two ways. We can decrease the fleet account, or we can address this article on the floor. It's in a paperclip. Do you have it?
Yeah, we have it here.
I have it, but I've misplaced or reshuffled.
It has a paperclip on it, two articles together?
Two
articles together, and they're on the regular article sheets. This is Town of Brookfield Annual Town Meeting.
No, I've somehow, what's it look like?
Looks just like.
It looks like that. All right. It's the trouble with letting me have these things early.
Oh. Always starts with the first place you look. Yep.
I started from the back. It was in the front.
So you were talking whether or not we should go higher with $100,000?
No, there's one or two things we can do.
Okay.
We made the argument to the advisory committee to up the fleet stabilization account
for
specifically the police chief. That was one of the largest arguments within other departments as well. He's placing this article. We have to do one of two things. We either stay with the figure that we had asked for with the advisory committee or place this article and decrease that amount that we asked for the advisory committee.
I'd say we stick with the original.
I think, we should stick with the original.
So deny this request?
Yeah, with the caveat that we had already planned for it someplace else.
So question to the chair. Did your committee, are you okay with $100,000 for the fleet repair replace account?
I believe that most members said no. I know they're gonna vote the other way.
So we as selectmen, traditionally, if we disagreed with the advisory committee's budget, we've changed the numbers before posting.
Yeah.
Do we want to accept this article, or do we want to use the plan of what we went for first and put the $100,000 in that line item?
I would talk to one article. That would be my recommendation.
You talk to two different things.
Well, it's not. It wouldn't be an article. It would be a line item on the budget.
It would be $100,000 for the fleet account.
You're talking dollars and cents, but you're talking two different articles, right?
No.
No.
We're talking about a line item in the budget, or we're talking on placing an article.
Okay.
Can we silence the phone, please?
Yeah, sure.
Thank you.
You're talking a dollar and two different articles, correct?
No, one's going to be an article. Police chief is proposing an article for $35,000 for a cruiser. The Board of Selectmen, a month or 2 months ago, proposed funding the fleet repair account with an intent to replace that vehicle.
So if it's only $35,000, why do you want to put $100,000 in?
Because we need a vehicle for the fire chief. We have potential.
That's my point. It's two articles and one figure.
There's no articles at all.
No.
It would be a line item in the selectmen's budget, in the town budget, where the department heads would come before the Board of Selectmen and ask for approval for a vehicle.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Two different things would come out of that $100,000.
Potentially, even more.
You never know, something else could. So you're
not going to get much more if you get 35.
Well, I thought that night, I thought you agreed.
I did too.
I thought you had agreed to go along with $100,000.
I don't think so.
So
we'll go back over to Ronnie.
All right,
do you remember?
So the board,
we were all.
I thought we were all set with the two.
I'll have to check the minutes for that.
Yeah.
Okay. The Board of Selectmen are not willing to place this article due to the fact that we
already put it someplace else.
Yeah. So we should probably let Mike know that thing.
All right. I'm putting an X on all that we don't, and a check.
Okay.
And you can go over there.
Keep things separate.
Next, to raise an appropriate transfer, borrow the sum of $14,400 to replace the two base radios at the station and one cruiser radio due to radio upgrades. So this has to be done.
Yeah.
Entertain a motion to place.
So I'll make the motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Now, this is what confused me, because I thought I saw... Bear with me for one sec. This is something new that we got today. Did you guys see a request for, previously, for a water department truck?
Right.
Not in this packet.
No, not in this packet.
I have this.
That's the one we got today.
Yeah, that's one we just got.
Oh, was it your phone call that said Mr. Clark brought it in today?
Yeah.
Is that where I'm getting confused? Okay, all right, so I retract.
So it comes out of their surplus account?
So the request was today. I apologize. It's been a long day.
Okay.
The request is from the water department to transfer from the water surplus account to the water system improvement account the sum of $35,000 to purchase a new truck for the water department or take any action relative thereto. This came up on our radar a couple months ago. The advisory committee was addressed in regards to this. I thought the advisory committee didn't want to do this. Did you guys have that discussion with Mr. Clark?
Yes, we did. We didn't really make any.
You didn't make a decision.
Determination. So, I don't think you know. I don't know how they're going to vote, but I would say no. I guess.
But it's coming out of.
I haven't checked.
But it's coming out of their water surplus account.
They haven't. We haven't made any official decision on it because they want me to go talk to Bruce and look the truck over. Before they decide anything.
What year is it?
I don't know.
Oh,
what year is it? Just a guess.
Three, I think.
Over 100?
Oh, yeah. He's had that.
It's got around 100.
He's had that for a long time.
106, I think.
And the purpose for replacement?
I'm sorry?
The purpose for replacement? The desire?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. The bed is rotting out. He's repaired it a couple of times.
All right, so I'll entertain a motion to place that article on the warrant.
I will make that motion.
No second.
Further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
This is a citizen's petition. This was just submitted today?
This is just submitted by the personnel board.
Mm-hmm. Why is it a citizen's petition?
Because
is this the new handbook?
No, this is, we were kind of misled. We were told that we didn't have to take this before the bylaw committee.
Which you don't.
No, we were told that we had to take it before the bylaw committee.
You don't.
Because we're going to be deleting some of it, and we're going to be amending some of the sections. So we were supposed to be taking this, we were told, to the bylaw committee, and we didn't have the time. So this is why we've decided to put it on with a
Technically, it's not a citizen's petition because it wasn't certified.
Did Michael certify
it? Did he certify it? I don't see a certification on it.
He should have today.
I don't see it, sir. But that's moot to me because I don't agree that it has to go before the bylaw committee, the selectmen place articles.
I want it placed. So
I want it placed also.
We need to certify it right now.
No, that's not even an issue. I don't want to play that game.
Because we've worked too long and hard on this. We've worked on this.
So can you go over real quick what the major rendition is?
Mary Lou.
Reading the final two pages of what the new bylaw would be.
So you're just deleting?
We're deleting several sections and leaving five paragraphs.
And then we're revising.
What are you revising?
Down here, it's section 1 through 6.
Section 1's on the first page?
Right here.
You're on my
section. It's over here. What you want? We want to delete.
This is section 1.
Oh, that's the old ones. We want to delete some of those, and we want to revise them here.
The bottom of the next to last page.
Next to the last page, right here. Delete all exception sections except the following sections as amended.
The thought is that the employee handbook would cover...
Yeah, would cover the most of it.
And we'll have the handbook in front of us in 2 weeks to approve.
Or even sooner.
Can I... See, the problem with a citizen's petition, and we're going to have this discussion with Mr. Blaze, is that if this is what a citizen gives us, this is what we have to place in the warrant. You don't want to print all this. This is going to be extremely confusing. So can I...
Mike Sarah told us we had support.
He also did that with Mr. Blaze. Can I make the recommendation that you just... And we can have this review with town council if they disagree with Mrs. Siri, because there's at least a dozen pages here. We don't want to print that in a warrant. So if I can make a recommendation of just maybe a paragraph, formulate... We'll put this as a holder to place it if we agree. Just coming up with a paragraph and saying deleting section, chapter sections, that'll cover what gets deleted, and then add this.
Mm-hmm.
So we don't have all that. It'll be in this, and that's legal.
It's not a straight add. It's amend as...
And town council can help us with that as well.
We can amend it.
Yeah.
And I think going over, if you provide something, I think that's part of town council's...
Yeah, because we would also like to provide the town council, as soon as we get it finished, we'd like to get the handbook into them also.
Well, that's something different than this. This is what we're asking the town to amend.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? To make it easier on the town floor, instead of townspeople saying...
I didn't really want to do that whole thing, but we were told we needed to.
Yeah, we were told we needed to, this is why we did it.
Is it something that you or the committee can put together just on that recommendation, and then we can, when we forward all this to town council, they can make... renditions?
Yeah.
Well, as soon as possible. It's on you to revise it. We don't need to send all of this. They have this on file. They have all our bylaws on file. So they can just tell us, you know, amend this, add this.
So would you like something, you know, that we would like to amend chapter 15 of the personnel bylaw?
Delete sections.
Delete the sections.
Through
it. Yes, delete. As soon as possible.
Yeah, as soon as possible.
We
have some lead time.
We add an extra week, let's put it that way. So within a week?
Okay.
Beautiful.
So we're going to set this aside then.
No.
We want to put this on.
I'm going to entertain a motion to place the bylaw revisions on as recommended by town council through submittal from the committee.
I will make that motion.
No, second.
Any further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Another one that you guys haven't seen until today, this is my rendition.
Oh.
We'd have to do the wording for it. I did not draft anything up because there's three different discussions we're having today in regards to the bathroom. First and foremost is do nothing at all, which we've already talked about, and just redo the bathroom, be done with it as a town vote. We've talked about trying to do this a couple of times. We've met with a lot of resistance. Mm-hmm. We discussed through the board, and this is just a revision for people listening, that we feel best to bring it before the town again so we're not deceiving the town on what we're doing. We talked about renovating the assessor's office and bringing that up to an ADA bathroom. Then we talked about possibly just doing the men's bathroom and keeping the assessor's office as is. So my request this evening is to do just that. Put a bathroom right here.
It's right there.
Right there?
It'd
be this wall to the center of that window.
Yep.
It's 9 by 18 feet, two plan. I broke down for you guys an Excel spreadsheet what I went over the costs for: framing, board and plaster, wonder board and tile, drop ceiling, electrical fixtures, two urinals, two plan with flushometers, not the hand ones but the sensors, two toilets with flushometers, two plan, two sinks and counter, the dividers and the grab bars for the accessible toilet, door and trim, and then this is the figure that's floating. Plumbing is $5,000. Everything is going to be done frame-wise and electrical-wise by Tantasco, so the only thing we have to pay for is material there. The only variable is plumbing. I've talked to two plumbers trying to get them in here. They're just so busy.
Mm-hmm.
So what I did is I took a number that I was comfortable with and added a couple grand to it.
Mm-hmm.
Just for a discussion, I got a project going in Spencer. It's a two-story house, two bathrooms, full kitchen, The plumber is charging me $7,000 for labor. I'm supplying all fixtures. Mm-hmm. I put in a $5,000 labor charge here for plumbing. We supply all the fixtures. So if I can get a two-story house done, I think we can get a, you know, four toilet bathroom done for five. The only variable in this that I see is a vent, plumbing for the vent. You never know where we can.
No, this is for a men. So are we gonna, what are we going to do for a woman?
This would be the first step. This would be to get this bathroom in here, right here. So they build mm-hmm. a wall. They build a wall. Okay. Put a door.
We don't have to move anybody.
We're not displacing anybody. Okay. We're getting an ADA bathroom. Okay. For this right here, my figure is $12,400.
Right.
Okay.
And so where I was kind of headed with it, now that we have these numbers, mm-hmm. is that the first part of the architect's work, which talked about the door sloops and all the rest of it, was a $50,000 number.
Yeah. I text Tantasco's teacher Sunday, asked him if I could meet with him yesterday. He said he's just too busy because he's getting back to school. He did walk with me a month ago. He has confirmed that they will do all the thresholds next year, and I'd like to incorporate the whole project into.
So where I was headed was that the for simplicity purposes, the $50,000 that was granted a year ago can be expended in this fashion, as well as much of the phase one work that was recommended.
So the phase one work was the door, because it's not wide enough,
yep.
The thresholds, and then an ADA bathroom, which was going to be the bathroom we currently have. Yep. We were going to do all that, mm-hmm. but there was a lot of turnback saying that it wasn't the intent of the town. So we want the intent to be clear,
yep.
because we talked about this at the special. We chose not to do it. Town council said the intent was there. We didn't have to do it. Met with a lot of resistance, so we didn't do it. So the way the article is going to be worded is to vote to transfer the sum of $50,000, if that's what's in there, mm-hmm. to a new account for specifically this and the door and thresholds.
And again, phase one work, because what I would want to make sure that we're also talking about is phase two is $880,000. It picks up the second restroom area as well as the elevator work. And that would be something out into the future, the next phase.
Well, first of all, it would be the future.
Yeah. Yep.
Second of all, we have a track record that we're proving that we can do this lower than what.
Get phase one done.
Because phase one was a $50,000 estimate by this company.
Right.
You're going to see that we're going to do it for probably half of that.
Right. No,
but this is just for a men's, so we're not doing anything then for the women's.
We're not doing anything to the existing bathroom. So you could use that as a woman's. You could use this as a woman's. Whatever you want to call it.
Yeah, but you want.
We would still have. I'd only put men's on this because that's what's on this plan. That's what it's designated as, a men's bathroom.
So you're going to finish that plan for this bid.
I'm going to do this master, and this price is with us. If Tantasco can't tile. I've already committed to me coming in here. They can throw a wonder board down. Anyone can throw a wonder board down, mortar it, and screw it. I'll come in here and tile it myself.
Okay.
So this is the intent, and we'll word the article to that, make it very clear, and then we'll have the discussion on the town floor. So this is just numbers for discussion of what I put together.
Mm-hmm.
The $50,000 is a true number. We're just transferring it for intent, for clarity, for transparency to the townspeople and the town floor.
Right.
All right. So entertain a motion to place that on.
I will make that motion.
Second.
Any further discussion?
No.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. All right. I think this is still in the order, so I think we can go towards the order that we're in. Where are you at? Yeah, Clarence, you have the same one? Beautiful.
All right,
so the highway departments.
Mm-hmm.
They have six articles on here. First is to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $1 to plow private roads, take any action relative thereto. We have to always have to do this.
Isn't this usually a line item, though?
It is. No, I think it's always.
It's in the block.
Yeah.
I thought it used to be a line item at one time.
I have the warrant with me if you need it.
Yeah.
So I'll entertain a motion to place an article.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion?
No.
Aye.
Aye. To see if the town will raise and appropriate the sum of $35,000 to fund the road reconstruction, construction and reconstruction account, take any action relative thereto. Entertain a motion to place.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Three, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $7,500 for centerline painting. Entertain a motion.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
All in favor of passing?
Aye.
To see if the town will vote to transfer $150 from the driveway permit account to the driveway repair account and take any action relative thereto. Entertained a motion to place?
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Number five, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate the sum of $4,700 to purchase materials for making repairs to the dump sander body for the 91 Mac and platform body for the 97 Ford to take any action relative thereto. Entertained a motion to place?
I'll make that motion.
I'll second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Number six, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate $10,000 to rehab the 1980 Mac to a catch basin or purchase a used truck to be retrofitted as a catch basin truck. Doesn't seem like a lot of money, but entertained a motion to place?
I'll make the motion.
Second.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. To see if the town, I had a discussion with Cindy last week, there was a request to do this, we do have the money in the fleet repair replace account to do this, Herb chose to place it as an article, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate transfer borrow a sum of $6,000 to repair the center pins and bushings for the 95 dresser loader.
Right.
Entertained a motion to place?
I'll make that motion.
I'll second.
Any discussion?
Why doesn't he want to take the money out of the fleet repair?
I have no idea.
Do you have any idea, Clyde?
No.
I asked Cindy to confirm, she called me back and said he wants it on.
I called her this morning to the triple concern, that confirmed, and she said yes.
All in favor?
Aye.
Cemetery commissioners, entertain a motion to place, to see if the town will vote to transfer borrow some, or raise a sum of $15,000 to build a new addition to the cemetery shed or take any action relative thereto. Tantascwa has volunteered to build a 30-by-24 shed next year with the town purchasing the materials. So entertain a motion to place that article?
I'll make the motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussion?
Yes, I just wanted to know, a lot of times they take money from an interest account or something that they have.
Well, that's where they have it, they can transfer internally.
Okay, so they can transfer internally.
We'd have to ask them whether they want to get it transferred first, and if they can't find the money, then that's on us and the advisory committee.
Okay.
All in favor?
Aye.
We really need to get all these on the same form.
Yes.
Yes, we do.
This is kind of silly.
I can send them a form.
I know. To see if the town will vote to transfer a sum of money for the ambulance receipts reserve account to fund the fiscal 2017 ambulance wage account or take any action relative thereto.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
To place, any discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
All right, to see if the town will vote, well, entertain a motion to place an article to see if the town will vote to transfer some of money from the receipts reserve account to fund the fiscal 2017 ambulance expense account.
I'll make the motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussion?
Wages account. One's wages, one's expenses.
No, this one's receipts revenue. She's got like two or three in here.
Okay, there's one for the ambulance expense account, and there's one for the ambulance wages account. That's what I have. One's wages, one's expenses, is that what you have?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, the wages is the first one.
They're both transferring from the receipts.
Right, from the receipts reserve.
One was for...
It used to say ambulance revenue, but...
She crossed it out.
Betty made me change it.
Oh, I thought Donna did, okay.
One was for wages, and the other one was for the expenses.
Right, okay.
So we took a vote, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
This is another issue that I'd asked not to place due to the same discussion, to see if the town, and if anyone's driven by that vehicle, the wheel well's rotten out, it's definitely time, to see if the town, but I don't agree for a sum of, I think it was like $45,000 that we've talked about, to see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate transfer borrow the sum to replace 2,000 cruiser for the fire department. So through the same argument, this was part of the discussion for raising that fee, I figure, not to place this.
Right, because we have the other.
Correct.
Maybe Mr. Martel wasn't here when we had discussed that earlier, I don't think.
So we spoke with the advisory committee a couple of months ago, and we argued to raise the fleet stabilization account to $100,000 with the purpose of both departments and vehicles. So with that in mind, we're not going to place this.
The chairman of the advisory board said that he felt would probably cover the fire department vehicle and the police chief's vehicle both out of free cash. So.
If we can't cover two vehicles for $100,000, we're doing something wrong.
Right.
All right, so we're not going to place this with that intent. To see if the town will vote to raise and appropriate transfer borrow a sum of money to purchase hydraulic rescue equipment for the fire department. Was there a sum here, Chief?
After some research, it should be under, I think $4,000 should cover it. I'll confirm that if I say a bit tomorrow.
And it physically failed?
Yes.
All right.
It's the original RAM. It's not serviceable, and it's outdated. That's why it failed. The last testing to the point that he didn't even want us to put it back in service in its current condition.
We have nothing?
Nothing on that one piece. We still have a spreader and cutter, but we've done without the RAM, so.
All right. Entertain a motion to place?
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. To see if the town will vote to raise appropriate transfer borrow a sum of money for vehicle replacement account or take any action relative thereto. I think this is the argument that the chief just made, that we should up that amount. So I would ask not to place this as well. He's asking for 200, we're asking for 100.
Right.
It'd be great to have 200 in there, but I just don't think it's realistic.
No, I don't think it is either.
Let's get the 100.
So we will not place that. To see if the town will vote to raise an appropriate transfer or borrow a sum of money to purchase air tank and protective clothing, a sum of $20,000. Every single year, Chief, this comes up. Are we just keep rotating over and over?
We're getting caught up on the air bottles. We've got a couple more years, and then that 15-year cycle on those catch up. And we're getting caught up on the protective clothing. The next big item that we need to do unilaterally is actually footwear, boots, for the personnel. So, and by doing a telling, we're able to encumber it. So 20 should take care of, we may have one more year after this to take care of some recurring things, but then the clothing is good for a few more years for the most part, and the bottles will be good for 15. So one or two more years, this and probably a smaller amount next year, will be good for a while.
And Dave, have you met with the chief to discuss this?
Yeah, he's gonna get us a breakdown,
This
the fluctuation of, year to year.
Yeah.
So we understand it better.
Well, this comes up every year, even when I was on the advisory
committee. That's why we asked him to get, he's waiting. Did you get that, Peter?
Yes, he
did. Yeah, we haven't reviewed it, so.
Yeah, right, so for placement, I'll entertain
him. We asked him, and he's given us a chat, the years, when the bottles are gonna be changed, so we can understand it better.
Entertain a motion to place that article?
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Further discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Mr. Snyder's request for to see if the town will raise appropriate borrow transfer in there as well, the sum of $13,500 for the removal of structures and debris. Do we want to stay with that weird number, or do we want to make it 15, or?
That's the estimate that I got from Kermit and Herb.
Okay. You think it'll go up by the winter?
No, actually, it started at 9, and then we found the debris at the waterside, so that we increased it enough to be able to clear that. I think we're good. I think we're heavy, if anything.
Okay. So entertain a motion to place.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Discussion?
Nope.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. All right, this is what we had talked about a couple months ago. This is what we brought forward 3 years ago. I worked with two other individuals, and we literally just...
Yeah, where are you?
The advisory committee turning into a finance committee.
Oh.
I
have the one from Mr. Cook.
Yeah, that's what I have.
All right, so can we grab the... it's a stapled one. It's got a line stricken through the top.
Yep.
Well, let me find it.
And I did move it strategically because Mr. Cook does have some issues with the advisory committee.
Okay.
So literally this is just melding that capital improvement planning committee and the advisory committee. And you can see section 2. Section 2 is literally the charge
of the Capital Improvement Planning Committee. So we're literally taking that committee, which has been non-existent for years. I think it's only been in existence for 2 years when Peter had really worked on that, getting that back up. Completely defunct. Bylaws say we need it. This would meld the two into a finance committee and eliminate the capital improvement bylaw. It's down and dirty. It's simple. It's literally changing nothing. I don't know why there was such contention at the other meeting.
Can I just go over real quick?
Take your time. And why I place this before the bylaw committees is because one of their recommendations is to change this and make it a 7-member committee as opposed to a 9-member committee.
So it's your proposal to strike.
What's that?
To strike the other. Just go with this.
What, are you talking about the bylaw committee's proposal?
Right.
That's where we need to have discussion, because if we're gonna take under advisement and agree that it should be a 7-member committee, then we should just revise this and mm-hmm. put 7 in here instead of 9. I don't agree it should be a 7-member committee. I think 9 is good.
9 is good.
Because
more of the merrier.
Yes, I think so too.
Share the workload.
Yes.
Now, what is, then we have the second page, and we're gonna.
This is all the bylaw. This is
the whole bylaw.
Yeah. You're changing the word advisory to finance, so it's now okay. A true finance committee.
Mm-hmm.
And it's melded.
Oh, this is how it's amended, all right.
Finance and it's committee. Melded into the Capital Improvement Planning Committee is melded into this.
Makes sense to me.
The only thing, let me read this here. Selectmen.
Did you have a chance to review it last night?
No, I didn't. I didn't realize that this was in town. Cut and dry.
Yeah, it's literally carbon copy. Yeah. So entertain a motion to place said article.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
This brings us to the bylaw committee's recommendations. Let's take it out of order. So the last, correct me if I'm wrong, I see 3 recommendations here.
Right.
So we'll take the third one.
Wait a minute, the one that I have is...
Yeah, he's a...
Chairman. Oh, they're all, okay, Mr. Cook, they're all
so
three
we have
on the,
one, two, three.
Oh, they're all three on the same thing.
So the third one is to change the 9 to 7.
Right.
We've decided that that's not a good thing.
Right.
Yeah.
All right, so we will not place that one. Back up to Article 30. To see if the town will vote to take any action relative to adding a new provision to the bylaws to the town of Brookfield, which would become chapter 11, section 20. Or chapter 2, section 20, that reads as follows, any expenditure, appropriation, board, bond, or borrowed amount exceeding $25,000 shall require the moderator to conduct a written ballot on voting for the article. I'm going to recommend that we do not place this for the simple fact that we're going to spend $3,400 on a voting machine.
Mm. I agree. Right?
And you're on the bylaw committee. Do you agree with that?
What's that now?
Not having a secret ballot vote because we're going to get the machines.
Right. Right.
So it's moot. Next article, to see if the town will vote to take any action relative to adding a new provision. You got to make this print bigger.
Yeah,
I'm dying here. And you have glasses on.
I know, me too.
No, you. To the bylaws of the town of Brookfield, which would become chapter
Two, section 21.
Two, it's a Roman numeral again, section 21. Everyone with glasses is laughing at me, I love it. And that's, that reads as follows, the annual town meeting shall take place on the first Monday evening in the month of June. I don't think we need to amend it.
We have the flexibility.
Yeah, we have that, so we're not gonna put that on here.
Agree not to place any of these?
Correct.
Yeah. But they can, like we said, they can come forward, we should have Karen let them know that we're not gonna put it, and like they can come forward to us.
Well, we have a member here, if you wanna reach back to the chair and let them know that we didn't place three of those.
Well, what will it hurt to put that on for Monday?
What?
Just so the townspeople can have some kind of input on themselves, for themselves.
Well, they already did.
Who did?
When they voted that it's a Friday on there already. If anything, we should just eliminate when we have a town meeting. We should just add
select. What does that say, Monday?
Monday.
And the bylaw says the first Friday after town elections.
Maybe you can revise it, anything besides Friday. I mean, or just put some kind of an article so we can at least get some kind of an input.
I've never been to a town meeting that's had issues in front of it that's been not very well attended, if that's not a double negative.
If people want to come out on a Friday, if they have specific issues they want, they're going to come out on a Friday.
They're going to come out any day of the week.
They're going to come out.
It's just our experience, Dave, and you've seen it yourself. We've had different days.
Okay. We've tried different days, and it doesn't work.
I think any day besides Friday is better than Friday.
We've tried them, Dave, over the years. All the years I've been with around, we've tried them all different days.
So for giggles, do we want to change the 10th to the Monday and see how it works?
That's where I was headed.
What's that mean? You're going to boost, what's that mean, the 13th then?
It would be the 6th.
Are you going to go back the other way?
Well, one of the things that we were discussing...
The 6th, and didn't we just have one on the 6th?
Well, one of the things that we did discuss was a lot of times, you know, people are going back, you know, to work for the weekend.
Monday is literally the worst day for me out of all the work. I'm absolutely swamped on Mondays, and to come to a town meeting and have be on my game.
I think two hours
would be minimum.
This is how we felt this morning when we discussed it. But then another point that was brought up too was to go in if we went over, say that we could go to a certain time, and say go to maybe 10:30, and then adjourn it to the next week.
But that supersedes the moderator. That'd be at the moderator's discretion as far as
I'm
concerned.
No, somebody can bring up the motion to do that.
At the town floor,
on the town floor. I think Monday's a bad day of the week because, you know, people are getting back from the weekends and, you know, they're trying to get adjusted.
I agree with you on that. I mean, I'm just saying, like I said before.
Well, your committee just brought forward Monday.
Yeah, I know, but now I'm just saying, if you're not happy with that,
people complain.
You can revise it to, you know.
People complain that we meet here on Tuesdays.
You can't make everybody happy.
So let's stay with the time.
I understand that.
So we're going to stay with
the 10th. Friday is all I'm saying.
Unfortunately, we're going to stay with the 10th, which is a Friday.
All right.
Next is a proposal to amend the bylaw. With the following underlying change, to see if the town will vote to authorize a revolving fund for the Brookfield Local Public Access under Mass General Law Chapter 44, Section 53E1/2, or any successor committee, and to authorize the license fee paid by Charter Cable and all monies raised through advertising and funding to be deposited in said revolving account, provided that no money shall be expended in excess of $30,000 per year or take any action relative thereto. Entertain a motion to place.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
All right. The only issue that I have here, and we can discuss this later, but just so I don't lose track of thought, is I had a request from the superintendent's office like 3 or 4 months ago that this be the first article on the town meeting, just so once they're done with their line item and answer these questions, they can go. They have five towns that they deal with. So that's just a courtesy to them. So a couple articles in here to see if the town will vote to strike the preamble to the Tantasca Regional School Agreement reading. This is all has all gone through their council. Obviously, we'll bring it through ours. They're just redoing this.
She explained that at the school budget hearing. All they're doing is like cleaning it up.
It hasn't been done since 52.
It hasn't been done since then.
So I'll entertain a motion to place that article.
I'll make that motion. So do we want to maybe move that?
No, I think there's a couple.
Do we want to move that up to number one?
Well, we'll worry about the placement at a later meeting. Okay. I just want to put on record that
so
they want
this. So this is the whole thing.
Well, there's a couple of
no, there's several
oh,
articles.
Okay.
So all in favor of placing Article 1 on?
I'll make that motion.
You did? All in favor?
Yep.
All right. Entertain a motion to place Article number 2 on. Again, just cleaning it up.
Same thing. I'll make that motion.
Second.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Article number 3, entertain a motion to place that article.
I'll make the motion.
Second.
So that's the third and final.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. So that's the last one.
So that's it, yeah.
Okay. All right. This is where it gets money. We have no choice with a citizen's petition that has been certified. Entertain a motion to, and this, we're not going to debate where we're at with it. We have to place it. We'll do that at a later meeting when we vote to support it or not support it. So I'll entertain a motion to place the citizen's petition from Mr. Cook for the abandoned housing initiative.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Entertain a motion to place Mr. Cook's petition for paying the advisory committee a $500 stipend per year.
Okay. Is that on
here? It's two. He's got two in here.
Oh, he's got another one. Okay. We've gone through this one too, but we have to put it on.
Yep.
I'll make the motion.
Yeah, it's been defeated every time we place it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Mr. Blaze, welcome, hello. Sir.
That's me.
How you doing?
Good.
Why don't you come join us, sir?
My turn.
Your turn. Welcome. All right, so reading this, again, certified citizen's petition, these are two different ones, right? Do you have two different petitions?
Yeah, I have one that refers to the town's bylaw, which is commercial.
Okay.
And one that refers to the zoning bylaw, which is residential.
Okay. Is there any possible way that
not
you...
Not today.
No, not today. We have a week.
No.
We asked you today. Yeah.
But actually, I can go through this in 15 minutes and let you know where the highlights are.
We know where the highlights are. Well, I know where the highlights are. Anybody that's been paying attention to Mr. Blaze's
yes.
communications.
Is basically the changes.
But my desire is to make the moderator's job on the town floor an easy job and to go through this and for the crowd to understand what your desire is without having to spend an hour on it. So if we can just clear up the language and if you're okay with it.
I'm having a hard time with language.
Okay.
And I don't think I can do it in a sentence or a paragraph. I could probably do it in a page. But
if it's a page, it's a page. It is what it is. But if you can work with Mr. Siri and our administrative assistant, I'd ask for that. And I don't even need a citizen petition. Well, I'll entertain a motion right now to place both articles on, with or without. No. Because technically what happens is a citizen petition, it's voided if the language changes because everyone that signs it.
Right.
But if we place it on, the intent is there.
No, I'm not exempting anything. I'm actually just adding.
Whatever you want to do.
Right.
I'm not really exempting anything.
And you can even do that on the town floor. You can submit this, and you can change it on the town floor and hand it to the town clerk and the moderator for a vote so they have it on file. So you can do either or. My desire is to make it clean and easy. So there's an intent there. We all know what we're talking about. The town floor knows what we're talking
can
about.
Can I ask?
We each have a copy.
Yep.
Right.
Can I ask a question, though, like with the planning board one? Usually, usually when you have planning board changes, they have to have hearings on this. The planning board has to have hearings, right, Sharon, when there's...
I would be willing to speak to that if the board let me.
I would entertain it.
Okay, would
because
you
I think
please?
Sharon's got some new information that it's important to
yeah.
the discussion.
Okay.
Share the table with your own.
Sure.
Right. Thanks. Mass General Law lays out a very specific procedure for amending zoning bylaws. Mm-hmm.
and Mr. Blaze has been before us a couple of times, and we've explained this to him. One of those requirements is that a hearing be held, one hearing be held, which is advertised twice. The first ad has to be placed no sooner than 15 days before the hearing. And then the hearing has to be held, and then the planning board has to give a recommendation to the select board about the proposed changes. Without that hearing, this petition, or if it's put in the form of a warrant article through the select board, will not be certified by the attorney general, whether or not it passes. The hearing is an absolute requirement. It's spelled out in Mass General Law, which you have a copy in front of you. The problem we're running into is that Mr. Blaze has presented this in a window that will not allow us, in a practical sense, to hold such a hearing before the warrant is printed up. So there's another wrinkle to this as well. If it's accepted, the Attorney General won't approve it unless procedure's been followed, which means it will be declared null and void. You'll be back where you started. If it's not approved, if it's voted down, and the Planning Board has not had a chance to weigh in on it, as I explained, Mr. Blaze, you, Planning Board, will not be able to even bring this subject up again for 2 years. That's also spelled out in Mass General Law.
So you want to go for it and have 2 years to think about it?
If you bring it up and procedure isn't followed and we don't get a chance to weigh in on it or advise you on it and it's voted down, you'll have to wait 2 years before taking any more action. I don't think that's what you wanted.
No. So, but you have two paths here. You have one petition that's a zoning-related petition, and you have one that is a town bylaw petition.
That's an important point. This only, what I'm talking about, only applies to the zoning bylaws.
Okay, doesn't apply this one. Just
right.
Applies, okay.
So if you were to go before the bylaw committee or whatever body Mr. Comtois suggested you go to, you could work on the town bylaws, because that isn't covered in what I just talked about.
And that was the only reason why he met with you, was bylaw. It had nothing to do with changing planning board issues. So you've actually gone above and beyond your original intent.
Well, since the petition I have, because I've received a lot of...
So my recommendation...
If I could give just one more bit of background. Mr. Blaze came before us, and he didn't know that there was a difference between town bylaws and planning bylaws, zoning bylaws, until we told him. He also didn't know that there was a difference between who covered what.
Right.
And he now knows that. Combining the two in one petition may be a problem, because... Mm-hmm.
So can I make a recommendation, Mr. Blaze? Withdraw these petitions?
So
if you want to put these on, we can. We'll place them, and then you'll have to wait 2 years.
No,
so my recommendation is to withdraw these two petitions and work with Ms. Mahoney and Mr. Cook, if you have to do it right.
Well, I think the recommendation really wants to be to work on the town bylaw, because it's very simple, very straightforward, that what we have is an inactive business that has a permit. We want that business to come back, a business like that, to be permitted there eventually. But what we're seeking is that we have some unregistered vehicles that are sitting in the back of the parking lot, and we would like them moved. By simply suggesting that if a business is actively pursuing business, then the bylaw applies. If the business isn't actively participating and working, then he should follow the recommendation and the vehicle should be moved. So I'm thinking you want to simplify.
I want to simplify as much as I can.
Yeah.
Okay, what if I do what you suggested, Mr. Comtois, and give you as short a version as I can
for the bylaw,
work with Ms. Mahoney with the planning board.
Yeah, for the planning board. Yeah.
And we've already offered to do that with you.
Okay, well, we'll do
at
that.
Subsequent meetings.
Now, I have another question. Does anybody realize or understand or know that is Brookfield Motor still in business?
Technically, yes. He has a valid license to sell used cars.
No, I mean, is it still for sale? Because his business, the sign is gone.
We don't know. Yeah.
Yes.
Well, we know he's permitted through February of 2017.
Okay.
That's what we know.
Mm-hmm. So to you, Mr. Cantor, I'm going to give you what you're requesting, and I'm going to work with Ms. Mahoney, With the planning board.
With the understanding that because of the requirement for a hearing, it may not make it into this annual town meeting.
Yes,
however, there is a special town meeting coming up in November. We can work toward that.
Okay.
So I'm going to entertain a motion to place Mr. Blaze's article for
town bylaw.
For the town bylaw with revisions, and not to and to note in the minutes that Mr. Blaze is withdrawing his personnel bylaw.
Zoning bylaw.
It's been a long day. So let's not have meetings on Tuesdays either, town meetings. Just so the minutes reflect, so we're not negating his right for the citizen petition.
And just as an aside, I'd like to get the zoning enforcement officer involved as well.
He's involved.
Because he has enforcement power. The planning board in and of itself does not have the power to enforce zoning bylaws.
He's met with Mr. Blaze, he's met with the bylaw committee.
And he's met with us as well. So if we worked on this together.
He's definitely an advocate for it. So with Mr. Blaze's agreement, I'll entertain a motion.
I'll make that motion.
Well, second.
Any further discussion? No. All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, everyone.
Thank you.
Keep
in touch.
Yeah.
I'll be in touch with you, but we'll
see you. So you want to be in touch. Thank you, sir.
Good time.
One step forward.
So, as far as I'm aware, that's it. Yes.
That's it.
I will entertain a motion to close the annual town warrant.
I'll make that motion.
I'll second it.
We'll deal with that later.
But we have the possibility, though, we could reopen it next week if somebody.
Well, in 2 weeks.
In 2 weeks we could reopen it.
I think the only ones that we didn't place that people didn't have interaction with was the bylaw committee.
Peter's got a question.
Yes. Okay.
Not familiar with the full text, the advisory board capital improvement change article you have on that. Does that also address repealing the current bylaw that establishes the capital improvement?
Yeah. Removing that bylaw completely.
Taking that, okay. Yeah. I didn't know that had to be a separate.
I thought it was. I've been asking Karen for the past couple weeks to look. She couldn't find it, but this will go through K&P as well.
Okay, because that bylaw is on there by doing this.
That's the intent, is to get rid of that and make that.
I didn't know if that would feel had to be a separate item or.
I think it was in there the way it was.
Yeah, what I gave you was exactly as it was voted on.
And we'll make sure with Michelle. And Michelle will be there at the meeting.
The other question on that item might be addressed in the text. Does that change the appointment of vacancies within that committee?
No, everything's the same. The only thing that does change is it reverts back to the initial charge is that the selectmen in the seat will put 9 people in. So instead of 3 people, replace all 9 people.
But any vacancies that happen during the year would be filled by that committee?
By the advisory committee, well, finance committee.
Yeah.
Do you think something should be different? Or?
That's been issues in the past. I've never really had an opinion on it. I know a lot of towns, you know, the moderator will fill vacancies, the board will fill vacancies. It's the only body in town that fills its own vacancies. So, I no opinion on the matter. Just
I hear you.
That question, I almost guarantee that question will come up.
There's going to be a lot of them. Yeah. All right. Item number 2, appointments. Election worker time. I'll entertain a motion to appoint Ms. Kay, Ms. Lazilli.
Lanzilli.
I don't see an N in there. Is it Lazilli?
How do you say Annette's last name, Karen?
I don't know.
Lazilli?
I'm going to say Lazilli.
Okay.
And Ms. LaPierre. Entertain said motion to appoint as election workers.
I'll make that motion.
The term to expire June 30th, 2016. All in favor?
Aye.
Item number 3, setting meeting dates. Was this our last meeting that's set?
Yes, you have to set it. But I want you to set it in 2 weeks on the 10th because somebody needs some financing papers signed then. So.
Okay, so we're going to meet on the 10th.
Well, 2 weeks is a
10th. Right. Yep. I'm just saying. Okay. So that that's one of the dates.
So we have May 10th, May 24th,
also understand that we're going to have to set a date once the advisory committee comes back to meet with them jointly.
Yeah.
We should probably do that on a day that we're not meeting.
Mm-hmm.
It depends on...
And then we want to go into June? Okay, let me get the June calendar. Okay.
So it'd be June 7th, June 21st.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm in July. 1 minute. Let me get over here. I'm just going to... Oh, okay. So we're going to go to June 7th?
June 21st.
Mm-hmm.
We really don't want to do July 5th, do we?
No.
Prefer not to.
Budget's going to be over by then. Do you want to go to the 12th, July 12th? And July 26th?
12 and 26th.
Are we good with that?
Okay, you want to do what? 12
and 26th? Yeah, July.
All right.
So entertain said motion to set those six dates.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
Discussion? Hearing none, all in favor?
Right.
Item number 4 is awarding roof repair contract. We do have money in the budget. We received 3 bids for replacing missing slate. The lowest bid with replacement of 120 of their slates, not our own. So to replace approximately 120 slates, I will entertain a motion to award said project to Mahan Slate Roofing for the amount of $7,900.
I will make that motion.
Second.
Any discussion?
What?
Hearing, what's that?
What would they, could we just see?
The other quotes were $14,500 and $8,700.
Okay.
All right. All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
It requires a signature. I haven't read the whole contract, so I'm not going to sign it until I read the whole contract. It has a signature line on the bottom. We don't have a wage authorization on the agenda.
Can we put that under other?
Not supposed to take votes for it, but I'll entertain it. The town clerk has... decided to use his assistant town clerk privilege. Going to be hiring, well, this is a current clerk for the Board of Health,
yes.
Isn't it?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
All right. I'm just going to throw it out there. Did the personnel committee sign off on this already?
Yes, they did.
Yeah, right. It's at a rate of $15.72. Yeah. That's what she's making now.
That was for Mike's assistant. We signed off on that yesterday.
Just for the meeting I was not at?
No, we did that yesterday, wasn't it?
I don't know. Personnel board, 419.
Oh, 419. I wasn't there either. No, neither one of us were. Oh, I thought they signed off on one yesterday, too.
So the argument for this salary is that's what she's making on the Board of Health.
Yeah.
So we good with that?
Yep.
Entertain a motion to allow to sign the wage authorization.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Aye. That's the only one in there, right? That's a resume underneath. There is no other.
I have a couple things too.
Ladies first.
All righty. I just wanted to let you know that our roundtable discussion went very well this morning, and I think there was a lot of good positive things came out of that. And they wanted to know, the next one will be the last Tuesday in May, which will be 5/31. And they wanted to know if they could discuss we could bring in and discuss the warrant, all the warrant articles, so they know just what's on the warrant.
It's going to be too late at that point.
No, they just wanted to see what was on the warrant so that we could discuss different things and just that everybody is on board with everything. Because a lot of times...
I'm not opposed to it.
Yeah.
But there's nothing we're going to be able to change by then. It's
we understand that. They just wanted to discuss, you know, each article so that everybody knows what's going on and there won't be any questions, you know, made by the other people on the floor. Mm-hmm. They just want to show the town that everybody's a united force with this, and they all, you know, they're getting along like that.
They all have their opinion. Just because they don't agree with it doesn't mean they're not united.
Well, this is what we discussed.
Yes, I'm fine.
And they wanted to know if one selectman is enough to have a discussion with them, or if we should have...
This goes back to, do we want to do department head meetings again?
Do you think it, because you're going to chair the next one, so do you think just having you there is enough?
It's fine with me, and or others. I mean, if others would like to participate, I'm fine.
But if we have enough, if we have it with two selectmen, then we have to post it.
Yeah.
If you're going to have it with two, you have it with three.
You have it with three.
We just post it.
And so, we go back to the department head meetings on Fridays.
But we're going to call it a round table.
Round table, and it'll be...
We're going to call it a department head meeting on a Friday.
No, this is the last Tuesday.
So my recommendation is to just do what we're doing. You do it, Clarence does it, then
Clarence
I do it.
Okay, so you'll do it by yourself.
May 31st at 10 a.m.
Didn't we say 9:30?
Well, we did it 10 o'clock this time, and a couple of people did suggest we'd start at 9:30.
9:30
I was here for 9:30.
And when I do it, it's going to start at 8 a.m.
Okay.
9:30.
And you're next after Clarence.
Okay, and then I have one more thing here. The chief had brought up...
Which chief? We have several.
Okay, I'm sorry. Chief of Police had brought up that, I guess, he was told by the town accountant that his phone bills weren't going to be paid out of the municipal account. And I talked to Holly, and Holly said that it was voted at the town meeting last year that all municipal phones would be paid out of the same budget item.
Did he change systems that increased it greatly?
Well, what happened was we are with Syntrex, and there's all kind of lines, I guess, that run here through the town. Yeah. And they were using it down at the old place, but they said they wouldn't need as many lines at the new station. And so it was put in by Verizon, but Verizon is actually Syntrex. And they are giving them a discount. So they said for the rest of this year, they don't have the money to pay the bills. You know, the bills would have to come out of the line item that was voted on at town meeting.
So this is the first I'm hearing of it.
It was the first I had heard of it, too.
I would assume that we don't have multiple phone line accounts.
No.
I'm sure we have just one. And for it not to be paid out of is just silly.
It should be paid. So then Holly's question was, she says, if the police have to pay the bills for FY17, she wants to know if they should go in and adjust the budget for next year.
That's a Betty question, if she wants a line item for the police station. I'm okay. It's the town.
I think we should pay all of their bills.
Well, the town of Brookfield pays all the bills.
Yeah, they do. So I think...
There's an argument to have a line item for the police station, but...
But I think we should leave it the way it is.
I'm not opposed to leaving it the way it is.
Okay.
Yeah.
So we'll leave it the way it is.
So can you please advise Betty that it needs to be paid out of the town?
Yeah, okay.
Out of the line item that's
We will tell her when she comes back in next week. Right. And I'll give Holly a call and tell her that we're leaving it the same.
All right. Through that round table, did you guys discuss the kitchen sink? Because we're going to have to...
No, we didn't discuss that at all.
We're just not going to talk about
it. Everything but the kitchen sink.
Everything but the kitchen sink.
There was no pun intended, but thank you.
We did. It was a good meeting this morning.
But we need to put our minds around that kitchen sink.
Mm.
I wasn't trying to. Now I'm laughing because, yeah, I get it. That was definitely taken out of context.
Because,
it'd be funny.
Because we were only, given till when?
I don't remember the date, but it's probably right around the corner. And we're going to have to decommission it.
So when it gets decommissioned.
So we don't want to advise the workers?
No.
No,
because we're looking at a $4,500 expense to run copper from there.
Oh, we're not running the copper.
Yeah.
Are they going to use, like, you know, if they don't have any running water? I mean, because they make coffee in the morning and they...
We have a sink over there. We have a bubbler over there.
You don't want to take it out of the bubbler.
We've been talking. I know Brenda brought up the idea of bringing a Poland Spring water thing in.
Sure. Get a service for now.
But if you're going to be taking that out of, if you're going to be making coffee every day, you don't want to take it out of the Poland Spring.
I'll tell you, I'd rather have coffee out of Poland Spring water than...
If we have to decommission, which is, that's the plan,
I would say
get portable water and be done with it.
Bring it in.
Yeah.
Do we have, what account would we...
We'd have to look for that.
We'd have to look and then budget for it for next year.
Yeah,
okay.
It's not that much money. We've had to do it other places. Yes, I do have another. I received two complaints over the weekend related to the racetrack and their activity. Going onto their Facebook account, there were 500, registered by their Facebook account were 571 people that were racing. That prompted me to relook at the Energy and Environmental Affairs summary of off-road vehicle safety laws. And what I relearned was that, in fact, persons under the age of 10 may only operate an age, size, appropriate dirt bike under directed adult supervision while in preparation for or while participating in a sanctioned event, which has been approved by the Municipal Permitting Authority. That would be us, I would believe.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Preparation for such an event may only occur on private property. What I'm suggesting is, and what I confirmed with the town clerk earlier, is that the racetrack is in no way permitted by the town.
No.
And so I just talked about 10-year-old kids. Tell me if the kid in the picture on Facebook on Sunday is 10 years old or not, or his buddy behind him.
No. And what surprises me...
We didn't hear that many.
Well, I think what you're confusing is that they have 571 likes. I don't think there were 571 people down there.
Oh, well, I don't know if I brought that page.
Because I had seen your email and I went into it, and we didn't hear that much noise down there on Sunday. I can honestly say that.
Yeah.
But the issue is that there's history with this, that the environmental police, and what town was it like a year or two ago? There was an injury with a child, and they were shut down. Where was that? About a year or so ago.
Palmer.
I thought it was Palmer.
Yep, I did too.
It was a major issue with the environmental police, and they're policing that now. I think that's our entity that we have to go to.
Yep.
And I forwarded this information to town council. So
thank you.
So does...
I forwarded it the same day. And
well, the emails that we saw had nothing to do with what we can do. It's what the current litigation is. Because I saw the email that came back, which concerned me because he didn't even answer as a politician. He didn't answer your question. You noticed that, correct?
Yeah.
So do we want to instruct the chief of police to reach out to the state or the feds?
I'm going to give this to the chief. I just went, because I had sent that email earlier to just...
But we need a connection with that entity to start policing this facility.
Yep, that's what it would be.
It should have been on their radar over a year ago. I'm concerned.
Yeah, there was an accident a year ago, and they did go down, and they did did at least do something on that day with the accident. But we're here a year later, a summer later, and what we have is kind of blatant disrespect to the town.
We wouldn't have known about the accident if I didn't come upon the scene last year.
Exactly.
I came upon the scene, and they were up there stopping the traffic, and I stopped, and I had asked the officer what was going on. Somebody had a broken leg down there. And the thing is, you know, they're using, I know we can't stop it, but they're using our ambulance facilities. Aren't they supposed to have their own private services? Because somebody had said that to me. Peter, can you?
I'm not familiar with it.
Because I know someone had told me at other races like this that these people hire their own private ambulance services to take care of this. And they have their own staff like that there, and not to use the town.
So I think it's just more awareness.
Yeah, more awareness.
And we just need to keep pushing.
So if we get the pushing is...
I'm going to give this to the chief.
Is reaching out to the chief, not only giving it to him, but giving him orders that he needs to reach out to the proper authorities.
Yep.
Because they have more teeth than the town of Brookfield
they
has.
Do. In fact, that's their law.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Any other correspondence? The Memorial Day Parade will be held Monday, May 30th, in memory of all veterans of all wars, starting at the elementary school, traditionally to the cemetery and then back to the town common, obviously weather permitting. This is under correspondence, so I think I would have liked it under the agenda. We can take it up later if we don't feel comfortable with it, but the Y, once again, would like to use the beach on South Pond for lessons. They have about 50 children for 2 weeks. The lessons would be July 18th to July 29th, run 2 hours from 1 to 3 o'clock. The Y will get the info out to the towns and in the papers. There would be only qualified instructors, and we would have a lifeguard on at that time for the entire beach. The lessons would still leave the East Brookfield side of the beach open for public swimming. Signups would be through the Y, and Miss McGeer would be the supervisor. She also lives on South Pond.
Remember last year there was an issue with the buoys? Mr. Landine came in to talk, remember the buoys?
Yeah.
Last year there was an issue, the swimming instructor, there was buoys, I guess they were in the weeds and then they weren't put out and...
Yeah, that was really a...
So what do you suggest?
That was really a rec committee issue about the Y camp.
Which I think's been rectified.
Yes.
Okay.
Jeff took care of it. Yeah.
So are we opposed to this, South Pond?
I'm sorry?
Are we opposed to this?
I'm not opposed, no. Absolutely not.
No, it's a good thing for the kids.
Yeah, I think it's a good program. I think it's a good program. It's been going on for years, so I ran it.
I'll entertain a motion to allow the Y.
And that's not the Frank and Dave camp, that's...
No, the Y.
No, it's the Y. Okay, I'll make the motion.
I'll second it.
Any discussion?
It's the Y camp out of Southbridge.
Yeah.
Yes.
They've done it down in Holland too for a few years.
Yeah.
Any discussion?
No.
Hearing none, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any other items on our minds?
Not tonight.
I'm gonna entertain a motion to adjourn.
I'd love that.
I'll make that motion.
Second.
We have discussion, we have none.
No, we don't.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye, thank you, everyone.